Welcome to the Great Exodus series. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. But today in the topic, we talk about empty shell. The Great Exodus series is God's plan of rescue for you. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion, your way to enter paradise. The empty shell is a life as a Christian that is not a true believer. Are you an empty shell? Are you outside a Christian, but inside you have no love, no unity, and no support for your neighbors? Are you only looking for yourself? Are you looking, oh, I hope I will be part of the rapture or the escape of the bride? This is already self-centered. But you are never doing anything for your neighbor. You are never doing anything for the needy. It's not enough to give $5 in a charity. It's not enough. You are commanded by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to produce fruits every day. A daily sacrifice of love is commanded to you. But I don't see anybody doing it. Very few people are doing that. A church cannot do it. Because a church is a system that is based on one pastor at the helm. And then after you have heard his sermon, you are going home into the world. So the churches that we have now are not really good for giving you a true worship or true, believing informations. No, what you need are assemblies of love and righteousness, where you be equal, where you support one another, where you share your resources. There is a great example that the Lord has given you in the book of Acts. Read what the first assemblies have done. This is what you have to copy and paste into your life. Come together in love, unity, and support in societies of the Rose. Walk with us that path to Mount Zion so that you can be raptured into paradise. If you only think about yourself, oh, how can I be raptured? How can I do this? Then you will never go to heaven nor to paradise. Take your cross as Jesus did and bring forth the love of the Father of Yahweh into the nations. We have created over the last 10 years a system that will allow you to do exactly that. To come together with true believers every day for love meals, for taking communion, and for doing a daily sacrifice every day, the whole year, bringing forth fruit, gathering the people, winning souls every day in the societies of the Rose. And then, when everything is complete, and the great harvest of the ages is in, then the Lord will send his angels to collect us from the four corners of the earth and will bring us to Mount Zion. And at that base, as a pattern to Mount Sinai, we will then have the ability to enter the holy place and to be raptured into paradise or to be sealed as one of the 144,000. So walk with us that path. Come together in societies of the Rose. You should enjoy that you have received an information where you can build such assemblies of love and righteousness. And you can do that by yourself in your neighborhood. Just learn about it. We have videos out. Watch the videos in the New Journey to Paradise series. Watch how you should establish them. And then you just go forward and do it. Who is holding you back? Who is stopping you from doing the righteous deeds? And who is stopping you from walking the righteous path? Nobody. Maybe your church. But then you should turn around and walk out of that church. Make your own assembly of love and righteousness and show the world what a true son or daughter of the Most High can do and will do and has to do. Show forth the love of the Father every day. and be supported by all of your people in your society of the host. Be equal. Make decisions together. Live a true life of faith and salvation within these societies of the host. Even the elders, there are two elders in every society of the host, a man and a woman. They are not elevated above any of the members. They're all equal. There's no pastoral system in a society of the host. It is a true assembly as recommended and shown in the book of Acts. So the book of Acts will come alive again through the societies of the host and through Triple Grace. Tell you, what will you do when judgments will fall? Your church is dispersed. Government cannot cope anymore. Who will come to your rescue? Then you are shouting to the Lord, where are you? But the Lord has shown you long time before that disaster came to you an open door. And has told you, walk through that path onto the narrow street towards Mount Zion. But you didn't. You remained in your complacency, and you remained in your churches, and you remained in the world, in your career, and you still fostered Babylon and still stayed with Babylon instead to come out. The Lord is calling you out of the world and out of Babylon right now. The door is open in front of you. Just come and walk with us towards Mount Zion. And you will be raptured into paradise. And you will receive your mansion at the slope of Mount Zion. The mansion that Jesus has promised you. So please, pray over it. Seek guidance and join us. The time is very short. The escape of the bride is at the door. And if you're not part of it, then you will stay here during disaster calamities. And I tell you, from all the people that say, oh, we will be part of the bride, only one will go. Are you that one? Do you know 100% that you will go in the escape of the bride? Are you so holy? Are you really a true Christian, not an empty shell? Most that I hear and see on YouTube are empty shells, talking, bickering, fighting over Bible verses that they do not understand themselves, that they pick out of context, and then they fight over it, and with bad words. Somebody told to me, oh, everything what I say is garbage. This person, what can you do with such a person? I did not even respond to these people. What for? The judgments are mine, says the Lord, so the Lord will judge them. The time will come when he will be asked, why have you said that to Michael? He has shown you the door, but you said everything is garbage. So you have selected the world, Satan and Babylon. And that's the end of it. There will be no escape of the bride for him, and no rapture into paradise if he is not changing and clean his clothes from the stained to white, as it is written, through the blood of the Lamb. So I will never answer people like that who say something like this. This is their opinion, and I know that the evil one is in many, many hearts, especially in the hearts who claim to be true Christians, who follow the gospel of prosperity, the gospel of poverty, the hyper-grace, once saved, always saved, all the things that human minds have developed. And they're all false and fake. Just read the whole Bible and then you understand. Read the Old Testament and the New Testament together in context. And then you will understand. Read the Revelation, the book of Revelation, just that book of Revelation, what is relevant now. Read it and you will understand and see that whatever these people are saying is false. Anyway, I hope you understand at least and will join us and walk with us that path to Mount Zion. It is not optional to be a righteous person. It's not optional to do righteous deeds. It is a commandment and it's a must. Matthew 25, read it there. At the end of the verses, where the Lord says, what have you done for me? And they say, no, we haven't done anything for you. Yes, and then the Lord will say, I do not know you, because you have nothing. You have not taken your cross, and you have nothing done for me. You have not visited the sick. You have not helped the Lazarus at your gates, and you have done nothing then to look for your own salvation. And you have looked for your own escape. But that is not the case. You have to take your cross and walk with the Lord together on that path towards the mountain, towards the throne of glory of the Father. And only if you become like Jesus as a true copy, then you will be allowed as a co-heir to enter the holy place. But this one you will never do by reciting Bible verses and then fighting over them, or by spreading false information and sticking to it and fighting and backstabbing and sitting in a church for half an hour in a week and then go back into the world and your careers. Will not do it. Will not make it. I tell you, it is not optional. Righteous deeds are a must. Yes, I know. It comes like a blow to many people. I know. But you have to understand that Jesus did all that work, not for you to sit behind your oven, but to come and go into the world, as he has commanded his apostles and disciples at the Lake of Tiberias. If you love me, feed my sheep. Are you feeding his sheep by backstabbing other Christians? Are you feeding his sheep by sitting in the church bench and then go home into the world? Of course not. You're not doing anything for the lost sheep of the Father. So join us, with us together. We are feeding the sheep daily. You also have to understand that you cannot hoard all your wealth that the Lord is giving you for yourself. You have to use the wealth for kingdom purposes. It's not enough to pay $5 for a charity. That most likely will misuse the funds anyway, because of the great overheads that they have. Instead, to establish a society of the rose, take all the funds together and do righteous deeds every day. This is taking your cross, and this is walking that path. I hope I made it clear for some people at least. Of course, I know this one who have fallen for the hyper-grace theories, once saved, always saved, this one for prosperity and this one for poverty. Only the Holy Spirit can guide them back onto the path. They are on the right, they are on the left, and they will fall down the hill. But there my words will fall onto dry ground. There will be nothing. No seed of mine will flourish at their place. I know that. In the same way as they've rejected Moses, in the same way as they've rejected the great Exodus. But the Lord will come with a mighty hand to shake heaven and earth. And then they will have no other choice than either to walk with the assemblies of love and righteousness, or they will die. Because alone you cannot make it. Only under the wings of the Father and only in unity can you survive the times that will come. It's bleak, it's terrible, it is persecution, it is tribulation. True. But it's not yet even the tribulation of the time of trumpets. That will come after 6 or 7 years. Not yet. But the seals will be open and Antichrist will be there. What will you do? Choose whom you want to serve. God the Father or the Antichrist? May God bless you and your family abundantly. This is Michael. I will see you again tomorrow. Do not be an empty shell. Fill your heart with love for one another, for the needy, for the nameless and faceless. Maranatha.